Right. Well, baby, you wasn't gone long. Look at this fire I got here.
You're not Charlie.
No, I don't think so. I know I ain't Charlie.
Well, where's Charlie?
He ain't here. He gave me the place for the weekend.
Oh, wow. I'm supposed to meet him here. Isn't this the 17th?
No, it's the 10th.
Really?
All day long.
Oh, shoot. I am always so confused, you know. I pose for calendars, but I never look at those little numbers.
I thought you looked familiar. I seen your picture on Charlie's wall in his office. You missed December.
Right, that's me.
But you sure wasn't dressed for it.
Well, you know those calendar people. I'm Gloria Jackson.
James Evans.
Oh, it is just a shame about this mix-up. You know, it took me 3 whole hours to drive up here in all that snow.
Oh, that's a shame.
Oh, that fire sure looks good. Do you mind if I warm up a little bit?
No. Lord, have mercy. Somebody tell me, so what were you two doing having lunch in the first place?
Celebrating finishing the inventory.
Now, we had a wonderful time once your wife got comfortable on the floor.
You want to run that by me again?
But I won't accept it. No. I gave this ring to Thelma because I love her and I want to marry her. Now, it's not yours to give back.
It's mine and I want to keep it. I knew you'd act like this. That's why I didn't want Donald to come here. What right do you have to plan my life?
We have every right. You're our daughter.
And you can't get married without our permission.
Well, next year I'll be 18 and I won't need anybody's permission.
Thelma,
Mr. Knight, I think you better let me do that. It's about time that you and my husband have a man-to-man talk.
Yes, Lord.
JJ, you go on over there to Willona's. I'm going to talk to Thelma.
Well, now that we men are all alone together, let me offer a few words.
Don't open that door. The thing went not home. Or better yet, I'll write a note saying we moved and shove it under the door.
I'll shove you under that door. Answer. Answer the door, Junior.
To dinner, but I didn't know she was gonna bring company.
Henrietta, I want you to meet the beautiful lady who made this historic meeting possible. My mother, Mrs. James Evans.
Oh, Mrs. Evans, this is one of my biggest thrills.
That's quite a compliment.
And I want you to meet the old block that I'm the chip off of. Father, James Evans Sr.
I'm the block, but the chip is cracked.
Okay, JJ, you've got a lot of explaining to do, so get with it, and I want the whole story.
We ain't gotta hear the whole story, baby. We can guess the beginning, because we done seen the middle. Come on out here, baby! Get your hands off.
Willona told me about that course that they are offering in the school. And...
Willona, I should have known the galloping gossip of the ghetto.
Now, James, you shouldn't say things like that about Willona. She's practically family.
Yeah, baby, tell me something. You've been knowing Willona longer than me. What does she look like with her mouth shut?
Hi, y'all.
Well, I guess I'll never know.
You're a killer threat. Why don't you have a little mercy on the girl?
Well, Dad, since she's gonna be my future fox, she might as well see the whole enchilada.
I don't believe that boy.
I tell you, baby, I mean, can you imagine anybody being that stuck on themselves?
Mm-hmm. I married him.
Well, now, wait a minute now, baby. I mean, I admit I am handsome.
Oh.
Well, you never heard me doing that much horn blowing.
Oh, come on, James. You blow so many horns, you could beat a whole brass section for Count Basie.
You gotta admit one thing, baby.
What?
We're making beautiful music together.
We sure have.
Oh, they're at it again. The Liz and Dick of the ghetto.
Well, Lona, do you ever even think about knocking?
Yeah. The thought has occurred to me. But I drove it right out of my mind. The bicentennial's getting next to me, and I want to be able to say I was there, and that's the way it was. Ho, 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 hey, hey.
Well, if you want to make it a real bicentennial, why don't you just visit us every 200 years?
Oh, James.
That's all right, Flo. We're just starting the fireworks a little early. Awfully quiet down here. Where are the kids? Oh, don't tell me they all left home and you was just getting ready to start another set.
Michael is in our room doing his homework. Thelma and Joanne Taylor are in there. She's helping her with some schoolwork.
Joanne Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, isn't she the high school homecoming queen?
Yep. Mm-hmm. And she's beautiful.
She sure is. She looks just like me when I was her age. And homecoming queen myself, huh?
You're a long way from home, sweetie.
You know, Flo, when I was a bridesmaid at your wedding, I remember thinking to myself, crazy. Here I am carrying a bouquet of roses just cause Flo caught herself a clump of poison ivy. Well, Lola, who's done it again? Give me five.
Well, that's it. Nice and quiet. Matter of fact, it's too quiet. Turn on the stereo.
The stereo?
The stereo.
Yeah. Give me a little exit music. I mean, make things sound normal around here. Dig?
Yeah, I dig. We don't want no trouble, Cletus. We don't want no trouble. Now, Thumb, do like you're saying, turn on the stereo. Dig?
Okay, Dad. That's just what I'll do.
Hey, be careful! Go back.
Come on, my son. Boy, you lucky he got to you first, Peter. Junior, stop all that bouncing around like a fool.
Are you all right, honey?
Am I? Relax, Flo. Everything's cool now, honey. Okay?
Cletus, I just don't understand. You were always such a good boy. You had dreams and ideals. What happened, son?
Do you know what it's like out there in Florida? I mean, scratching and scrounging for every little penny. I mean, what you gotta do to make it if you're poor today?
Damn if I know, Cletus. See, we so rich, we don't know. We've been sitting up here in this big penthouse on Lakeshore Drive, and all we do all day long, son, is eat caviar, count our stocks and bonds. What the hell would we know about being poor? Huh? Yeah, come on in.
Do you mind if we make another telephone call? We've been waiting downstairs, and that cab still hasn't shown up.
Yeah, but look who has.
Hey, what do you know? Cletus Jackson.
JJ, get the suitcase with the money in it.
Here's his gun.
You did have to remember that, didn't you, Dad?
Get the suitcase, boy.
Just jiving.
Hello, this is Special Investigator Monroe, FBI. We've got an emergency here. We need transportation fast. 963 North Gilbert Avenue. You got it? Thank you.
Okay, let's go.
Thanks a lot for helping us out, Mr. Evans.
Yeah.
And Mrs. Evans, I'm sorry it turned out this way.
So am I.
Daddy?
Yeah?
I want to apologize.
For what, Michael?
For thinking Cletus was a hero. I acted just like a kid.
Oh, that's all right, son. You didn't know no better.
But I do know one thing for sure. When it comes to heroes, there's only one in this house.
Well, it's nice of you to say that, little brother.
JJ, I was talking about Daddy.
Oh, now, Michael, as much as I appreciate that, I ain't no hero. You have to be no hero to catch a chump like that. No, I think, son, if you're talking about heroes, you're thinking about people like Martin Luther King or Thurgood Marshall or Medgar Evers.
And James Evans Sr.
Right on, right on. James Evans Sr. You didn't say that, Mr.
You've been outvoted.
What's he doing?